The government is basically making it up as they go along. There's a learning curve, basically, because we've never seen three nuclear power plants liquefy because of the enormous heat. And it's going to go on for 40 years. 40 years is a reasonable estimate. Look at Chernobyl. 30 years after the Chernobyl disaster, they're still trying to figure out what to do with that melted core, which is continuing to melt into the Earth.
That's a long time, isn't it, to have to pay for something that the government should have had a handle on?
Right. And we know the steps that have to be done. First, you have to send in submarines to photograph the core, find out where it's melted. Then you got to bring in hacksaws to hack up the core, remove huge chunks, like we did at Three Mile Island. So we have a lot of experience with this, except here the core is liquefied. We've never seen cores liquefied before, three of them. And so we're still trying to figure out the geometry of the melted core. We're nowhere near doing that yet. And the problem is workers cannot go in other than just for a few minutes because the radiation levels are lethal. So the United States Pentagon has created the DARPA challenge to create a robot that can pick up objects, sweep the floor, turn a valve. But so far, almost all the robots have failed to do simple chores like clean up the radioactive debris.
So isn't there a role here for some of these major technology companies like Google's to go in and basically create a robot that really works? Because we've already seen driverless cars. It's not like this couldn't be done.
It's a technical problem, but it's a very big technical problem. That's why the Pentagon created the DARPA challenge. So far, of all the groups, only the South Korean group came close to carrying out the chore of sweeping the floor, turning a valve. It's things that a child could do, our most advanced robots cannot do. We've been brainwashed by Hollywood into thinking that robots can do everything we can. It doesn't work that way.
So you're saying they're just not as advanced as we've been led to believe. A lot of conversation, of course, around the World Economic Forum this year in Davos about the fourth industrial revolution, you know, robots taking jobs away from humans.
Yeah,
I
was there at Davos, and I told people, hold on to your horses. No robot is taking over anytime soon. They're not going to put us in zoos, throw peanuts at us, and make us dance behind bars. It don't work that way. Our most advanced robot has the intelligence of a cockroach. A cockroach. That's how our most advanced robots are. We got a long ways to go before they're as intelligent as a dog or a cat.
Michio, thanks so much for joining CNBC.
My pleasure.